As we have been praising and worshiping the Lord, let us now invoke our Blessed Mother, Mary, Mother of Priests, to accompany us and to help us to listen to the Lord, listen to the Word of God. And so let us pray, Hail Mary, full of grace,
the Lord is with you.
Blessed are you among women,
blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Amen.
Good evening to all of you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening, Bishop.
As Father George said, that is the first time we are coming together as the prayer meeting for the bishops and priests. And they asked me, since this is the first meeting, you shall share some message for this prayer meeting. Since it is the first meeting, then we'll have different people will be sharing in the following meetings. I thought, I have some familiar faces here. I know Father Varghese Thaipodat. Father Edward Sallana is from Jamshedpur, no? Yes. So some of you, I reckon, Father Robin Dice, surely. So I welcome each one of you for this prayer session. I think we are about 35 participants. I hope in the future meetings the number may go up. We as priests, we are very dear to Jesus, very closer to the heart of Jesus. Because as Jesus, as St. John Mary Vianney would say, the greatest gift of God to mankind is the Eucharist, the greatest gift. And Eucharist cannot be without a priest. Priest makes the Eucharist, and Eucharist makes the priest. And so, I can very well say, the priesthood is also the greatest gift of God to mankind. So, we as priests are gifts to mankind. Let's realize that. Today, we are taking the place of Jesus. And we are speaking the words of Jesus. We are doing the mission of Jesus. We are pronouncing the words of Jesus. And so a priest is very dear to the heart of Jesus. And Jesus is very close and very dear to the heart of every priest. And we as priests should enjoy that intimacy. Now, unless and until we enjoy this deep intimacy with Jesus, unless and until we share the same mind and heart of Jesus, we cannot be what we are called to be, priests. And that's why I thought in this short message, I want to reflect with you about our intimacy with Jesus, how much we are intimately united with Jesus in order to really represent Him, in order to really have the real power of Jesus in us, in order to do His mission as He would do it. And so we need to have that deep intimacy. In other words, we need to be united with Him. We need to have a deeper union with Jesus. That union with Jesus is through a life of prayer. And of course, the prayer is a relationship for us. Prayer is not just what we do, the liturgy of the hours, the Holy Eucharist that we celebrate, the rosary that we say, and the personal prayers that we have. It's not only that, but these are the means to make the whole life a relationship with Jesus. Every moment we should be related with Jesus. Every moment we should be intimately connected with Jesus. Every moment we should be enjoying the intimacy with Jesus. And that's why I would like to reflect with you the first day of our prayer meeting as priests together on the call to intimacy. Our vocation is a call to intimacy. I'll be taking from St. John's Gospel, If you really go through the four chapters of St. John's Gospel, chapter 14, 15, 16, 17, 14, 15, 16, 17 of St. John's Gospel clearly manifests to us, enumerate to us the intimacy Jesus had with the apostles. We can read through these four chapters and we can experience the intimacy Jesus had with his apostles. So I would like to pick up some signs of this intimacy, and we will reflect whether do I have the same signs in me, in my relationship with my Jesus. Do I have these signs so that I can really be confirmed that yes, I am in intimacy with Jesus. So there are 9 signs of intimacy that I have picked up from these 4 chapters. 9 signs of intimacy, and I would like to share with you the 9 signs of intimacy so that we can examine ourselves and see whether am I really in intimacy with Jesus, because my call as a priest is to live a life of intimacy with Jesus. And it is from this life of intimacy flows the mission. Whatever I do, whatever I speak, whatever I think, to my relationships, everything should be inspired and animated through the life of intimacy that I have with Jesus. So the first sign that I take up is complete sharing. The first sign of intimacy is complete sharing. The reference for that is John 15, 15. The Gospel of John, chapter 15, verse 15. I read it to you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. How beautiful it is. Jesus is addressing the apostles and he is telling them, I don't call you servants any longer. You are not my servant. Because today as priests, sometimes we can have this tendency of doing work. As servants, we are busy with so many activities. We are busy with so many assignments. And we are busy working. And sometimes our identity we take from the work that we do, the functions that we have. And so we get our identity from the functions. That's not right. Jesus very clearly says, I have not called you servants any longer, but I call you friends, companions, friends. Because all that the Father has revealed this to me, I share it with you. A total sharing of Jesus with us. That's what the first sign of intimacy. Jesus shares of his everything to me. All that the Father has given to me, I give to you. Receive my spirit. He gave us his flesh and blood. He gave us everything. He emptied himself on us. And then he also gave his own mother as our mother. The last moment from the cross. So he has shared everything with us. A complete sharing Jesus has done with me because I am his priest. And so do I share completely with my Jesus? Do I share all that I am going through? When we have some difficulties or some problems, usually we go to our friends first. When nothing works, then we come to prayer. But do we go to the Lord? And so he should be the first person that I must share with. Whatever I have, whatever I go through, my problems, my difficulties, or even the achievements that I have, the happiness, the satisfaction, I must first share with my Jesus, who is my first and best friend. So I must now share with my Jesus everything of my life. He should be the first person that I should share with. And then the other human friends. So we must make it our life. First thing, first sign of intimacy is complete sharing with Jesus, because we are not his servants, we are his friends, we are his companions. As a priest, we must take this pride. Second sign of intimacy is choice of friendship. Choice of friendship. How Jesus has chosen me as his friend. The next verse, John chapter 15, verse 16, first part. Verse 16, first part. You did not choose me, but I chose you. You did not choose me, but I chose you. So Jesus is telling me, I as a priest, today Jesus is telling me in his intimacy that I have chosen you. When we read in the Gospel of St. Mark, before calling the disciples, he says, he called those whom he desired. He called those whom he wanted. So I am being wanted by the Lord. I must experience. I must have that deep conviction that I am being wanted by the Lord. I have been desired by the Lord. I have been chosen by the Lord. The conviction of being chosen by the Lord. Every moment I must cherish this conviction that the Lord has chosen me. Even when I go through difficulties, when I have temptations, when I have fallen, when I have committed a sin, even that moment I must realize I have been chosen by God. I have been chosen by Jesus. I am a chosen one. I am a specially favored one. So I, as a priest, is a chosen person. That's why Jesus says, you did not choose me, but I chose you. Now, I must have the same sign of intimacy in my life with Jesus. So I must choose him as my first and best friend. So today I must choose him as my first and best friend. So I must choose him in everything. A deliberate choice of Christ as my first and best friend. No one should come above Jesus. So he must become my first and best friend. So that is the second sign of intimacy. Is Jesus your first and best friend? Is there anything, any person, any things, any attachments takes the place of Jesus or becomes your priority? Today we must analyze and see. If it is so, we must give up and we must make Jesus as our first and best friend. That is the second sign of intimacy as a priest. So that is one. And the third sign of intimacy is suffer for the friend. Third sign of intimacy is suffer for the friend. Again, we have the reference, John's Gospel, chapter 15, verse 13. I read it to you, verse 13. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. So that is a sacrifice of the Lord has made for me. He has laid down his life for me. So he says, no one has greater love than this, than to lay down his life for his friend. That is the third sign of intimacy. Since he loves me, he is in intimacy with me, he has given his life for me. Am I in my intimacy for Jesus, am I ready to lay down my life for Jesus? Am I ready to sacrifice my everything for my Jesus, whom I see in my brothers and sisters? The Jesus who is my intimate friend, whom I see today in my brothers and sisters. Am I ready to sacrifice myself for my brothers and sisters in whom I see my intimate friend, Jesus? So that's what sacrifice means. So friendship means sacrifice. There cannot be a genuine friendship without sacrifice. And so that is the third sign of intimacy, suffer for the friend. Am I ready to take up difficulties, sufferings, misunderstandings, hardships, inconveniences for my Jesus, for his task, for his mission, for his love, for the service of my brothers and sisters? Am I ready to take up struggles, difficulties, problems, misunderstandings when I am involved in my love and service for my brothers and sisters in whom I see my intimate friend Jesus? Whatever you have done to the least of these, you did it to me. Jesus is identifying. And so I must sacrifice myself for my brother Jesus, my intimate friend Jesus, whom I see in my brothers and sisters. Fourth sign of intimacy is not possessive friendship. The fourth sign of intimacy is not possessive friendship. Again, the reference is John chapter 15, verse 16, second part. The 16th verse, second part. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. So I have appointed you to go and bear fruit. So the fourth sign of intimacy is to bear fruit, to be fruitful. A friendship should become fruitful, not for possessive friendship. That's why Jesus said, I have appointed you to go and bear fruit. So our prayer life should be fruitful. Our prayer life should not be selfish, self-satisfaction. Sometimes it happens. Sometimes our spiritual duties we perform in order to get some self-satisfaction. There are people who are all the time sitting in the chapel and praying, but they are not able to live a proper community life. They are not able to relate properly with each other. They are not able to understand each other. That is a possessive friendship. Mary Magdalene, when she was clinging to the risen Lord, she wanted to be with him. What did Jesus say? No, don't cling to me. Go and tell my brothers that I will meet them in Jerusalem. I have risen. I am risen. Give that message to them. So the more we come closer to Jesus in intimacy, the more we should be closer to our brothers and sisters, closer to every person. We should be more loving, more understanding, more forgiving, more serving. That is the sign of intimacy. Am I really loving and serving to the people? Am I really understanding person? Then we can say, yes, I am in intimacy with Jesus. So the fourth sign of is not possessive friendship, not for my own satisfaction, but to sacrifice myself. So that's what Jesus is saying. You go and bear fruit. My relationship with Jesus, my prayer life should be fruitful. It should be beneficial to others. It should make me to more loving and serving. So that is Vincent de Paul. Saint Vincent de Paul calls that leaving God for God. Suppose you are in your prayer. Somebody is in need of your help, standing outside waiting for you. That's the time the person is in need. You must leave your prayer and go and help that person. He is in need of you. So that is called leaving God for God. So that is a sign of intimacy. Fifth sign of intimacy. Friends are of one mind and one heart. Friends are of one mind and one heart. We should have the same mind and heart of Jesus if you are really in intimacy with him. The reference is John 14, verse 21. John 14, verse 21, we read, they who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me, and those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them, and I will reveal myself to them. So those who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me, and those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them. So that is what having the same mind and heart, of one mind and one heart, through the reading and reflection of the gospel and prayer, we must acquire Christ's way of thinking and Christ's way of doing. So through the reading and reflection of the gospel and prayer, we should acquire Christ's way of thinking, Christ's way of doing, and loving those things and persons which Christ loves. In other words, we should really enter into the heart and mind of Jesus and become of one mind and one heart with Jesus. That's a sign of intimacy. Having the same attitude, same mind, same way of thinking, same way of doing of Jesus. That's why a priest is called an alter Christus. That's why we are called to be configured to Christ. The formation we read, philosophy is a discipleship program. theology is called being configured to Christ. So the formation should help us to be configured to Christ, having the same mind and heart of Jesus. The sixth sign of intimacy is concern about the friend. Concern for the friend. John 14, verse 15 to 17. John 14, 15 to 17. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him because he abides with you and he will be in you. See the concern of Jesus. When he is leaving the disciples, he is saying, I am not leaving you orphaned, but I am giving you another advocate to be with you, to help you, to empower you, to sanctify you, and to reveal everything to you. So he is concerned about his apostles. Do I have the same concern for my Jesus? Am I concerned about the glory of God? Or do I try to adjust and do away? Or am I concerned with the glory of God? Am I concerned with Jesus? Am I concerned with his mission? Am I concerned with the church? Am I concerned about what is happening in the church? Am I concerned about the name of the church? Or am I really criticizing the church, criticizing the personnel of the church? Or am I praying that they may get converted, they may get transformed, they may leave the evil ways? Am I concerned about the church? Am I concerned about the Lord, his mission? So that should be our concern. Jesus is concerned about me. That's why he has given another advocate. He has given me the Spirit. He breathed into me and said, receive the Spirit. That is his concern. I am being empowered by the Spirit through baptism, the sacrament of baptism, through confirmation. And then the baptism in the Holy Spirit, every time when I pray, every time when I read the Word of God, I am baptized in the Spirit. I am strengthened in the Spirit. That is his concern. Am I concerned about Jesus and his mission in his church and his personal? I am concerned about the life of priests, life of religious who are the leaders in the church. That should be my concern. Or am I negatively criticizing the church? Seventh sign of intimacy, sorrow of separation. John 16, verse 16. Jesus says, a little while and you will no longer see me. And again a little while and you will see me. So Jesus is now feeling the sadness of being separated from his apostles. A little while I will be with you, afterwards I will not see you, you will not see me. He's feeling that. So the sorrow of separation, Jesus is experiencing the sorrow of separation from his intimate friends, from his beloved. Do I feel the same sorrow when I am separated from Jesus? What separates me from Jesus? Sin separates me from Jesus. Sin takes away from God. Sin is the one that separates me from Jesus. Do I have the dread for sin, which separates me from Jesus? Do I have sorrow for my sins? Jesus was sorrowful when he was separated from his disciples. That shows his intimacy with them. Do I have sorrow for my sins? Or am I really saying, oh, it's okay, it's fine, and carrying on? So we must have dread for sin, sorrow for our sinfulness. That shows the intimacy. If you're really in intimacy with Jesus, we will have that sorrow for our sinfulness. Then the eighth point, the eighth sign of intimacy, that is happiness in the intimate friendship. Happiness in the intimate friendship. John 15, verse 11. John 15, verse 11. We read, I have said this thing to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that joy may be complete. Jesus is concerned about me. And he wants me to be having enjoying the complete joy. Jesus, the source of joy, is within me. So am I having that joy in my friendship with Jesus? Am I experiencing that real joy of being with the Lord, being in the mission of the Lord, being preoccupied with the Lord's affairs? Am I enjoying? Am I having that happiness? Or am I grumbling and doing all that? So Jesus wants us to be joyful. And that's why He is the source of joy within me. We must be joyful. As priests, as anointed person, we should be joyful. That's why Pope Francis would say, a gloomy religious is a contradiction. And the same thing can apply to us. A gloomy priest is a contradiction. Because we are taking the place of Jesus. Jesus is a source of joy. He is within me. I must be always joyful, even in the midst of afflictions, difficulties, problems. I must be joyful. I should never allow that joy to go away. That is my intimacy with Jesus. And the last one, ninth one, the sign of intimacy is, a friend wants to be always with the one he loves. The abiding presence. A friend wants to be always with the one he loves. Jesus always wants to be with us. John 14 verse 23. John 14 verse 23. Jesus answered him, those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them. We will come to them and make our home with them. So Jesus is saying He wants to abide in us. He wants to live in us. He wants to be always with us because He loves me. When we are in love with somebody, we want to be with that person. A friend wants to be always with the one whom he loves. And that is a sign of intimacy. Am I always with the Lord? That is what having the contemplative spirit. Constantly being aware of the presence of God who is within me. I must be able to do that. I must be always be aware of the presence of God who is within me. The constant awareness of the presence of God within me. That's why we sometimes take the name of Jesus, Naam Jap, ejaculations. These are the means that we try to keep the presence of Jesus within us. We must live in the presence of Jesus, the constant awareness of being with the Lord. That is the ninth sign of intimacy. I just give an example and I complete. That is, you look at a cow. This is called the contemplative spirit. A cow, mother cow, is tied to a rope and the other end of the rope is tied to a peg. So the mother cow is grazing, means eating grass. And the calf is let loose. The calf is with the mother cow. Now you must watch that. Notice that. The calf will be simply jumping up and down, running up and down. And the calf is not bothered about the mother cow. But the mother cow, the one eye of the mother cow is following that little fellow wherever he goes away. He keeps jumping and pudaktarata. So the mother cow is having one eye of the mother cow is following the little fellow where he is going. The moment the calf disappears from the scene, is no more visible, the mother cow will lift its head and make a cry, Ma, where are you? It will call on to it. So there is a contemplative spirit existing between the mother cow and the calf. The calf is not bothered about, but the mother cow. That's what is between God and me. God is always mindful of me. That is His intimacy. Jesus is always with me. He told me, I'm with you till the end of time. So He is with me. But I am preoccupied with so many things. I don't even experience sometimes His presence. I'm so preoccupied like that little calf. But then His eye is always following me. I must experience that. Let's suppose that calf now comes back to the mother cow, comes closer to it. What happens? It drinks milk and the mother cow licks it, shows love. You can see that beautiful scenery when the calf turns to the mother cow, how experience it is. A deep intimacy we can see between the cow and the calf. The same thing we will be able to experience when we come back to the Lord. When we become aware of Him, we'll experience that love, that intimacy with Jesus. That's what having contemplative spirit. So that is what every priest is supposed to experience every moment. Once we are in this intimacy with Jesus, everything that we do, everything that we speak, every relationship will become a mission. And that's what today is in need of. Without this, we will do many things, but that is not going to be the mission of Jesus. What today every priest is in need of is having that deep intimacy with Jesus, cultivating that deep intimacy. Then we will not get into depression, get into kind of a disheartening. And that's why many, even it's very unfortunate, some of the priests ending up in suicides and psychologically imbalanced, then they have to be treated, etc., etc. It's because we are lacking that deep intimacy with Jesus. We have to enjoy that. We as priests are called to a life of intimacy. So that's what I just shared with you. We need to have this deep intimacy with Jesus. Let us pray in a special way that the Lord may give this gift of intimacy to all of us who are priests. Thank you.